So, good evening, everybody. Dear members of the organizing committee, distinguished speakers, critical thinkers, critical theorists, conference participants, colleagues, and friends. It's a great honor for me to welcome you in Athens for the 13th conference of the European Sociological Association. As I was preparing my notes for this welcome speech, I just remember myself when I was young student in the area of social policy, but I also remember myself as a master student, as a PhD student. All those things took place sometime mid-90s, and I remember very well on that time that it was a period of major transformations across Europe, in the society as a whole, but it was also a period of major transformations across the academic environment, universities, research centers alike. So it was a period of relative prosperity for most European Union countries, including Greece, including Ireland, including Spain. It was a period of relative prosperity for what we know as the European Union, that on that time it was refined, it was expanded, both in geographical but also in institutional terms. And the recurring idea of those days was that we need more and more Europe. So what this Europe of which we needed more and more, that was a mystery to many, and especially to those that were in greater need, of course. So in what concerns social, academic, and scientific debates, all those debates were clustered about buzzwords, as it usually happens with the way media operates, and a lot of catchphrases such as the so-called end of history, the so-called end of work, all those latest theories about globalization and its repercussions for the economy and the society, and so on. And all those ideas and debates were taking place amidst a rapidly changing academia, where its main elements was the marketization of universities, the cutting down of public spending, especially for social sciences departments, new public management and managerialism, the revenge of Thatcherism across the education, the expansion of a new paradigm in academia, several elements of which, unfortunately, were incorporated into the Bologna process and declaration, a process that, of course, did harmonize the architecture of the European higher education system at a significant cost, though, for intellectual life and academic freedom. So what we were facing on that time, of course, younger people were more frustrated with the situation, not other segments of the workforce that were more or less more protected than the others, but what we were facing on that time was the establishment, step by step, of the neoliberal paradigm. It's been almost two decades since that period, and here we are today, junior, senior sociologists, distinguished speakers, gathered together in my city, in Athens, and a country that I think symbolizes a lot of things, but also symbolizes, perhaps in the most exemplar way, the failure of the neoliberal paradigm. I'm saying this taking into consideration national peculiarities as well. So what we shall be debating in the following days is the unmaking on Europe, the ills and opportunities of late capitalism, and the perspectives towards a better future for sociology, your profession, and our societies alike. And admittedly, this debate is not only timely or even urgent, but also increasingly complex. Complex in a Europe that faces the Brexit challenge, the rise of nationalism, the dismantling of the social base in countries such as Greece that have been ravaged by years of austerity. The impact, of course, of climate change, as well as other more ambiguous and multifaceted developments such as the rise of algorithm-based communication and economy, the use of big data to interpret, sometimes manipulate and predict human behavior, and so on. So if we are here to reestablish sociology as a necessary scientific tool for contemporary societies and, of course, the policy makers. We need to revisit its founders' reasoning on why people should continue practicing the discipline in the first place. Identify social problems, explain them, suggest applicable solutions to resolve them. Rephrasing Marx, most sociologists have only attempted to interpret the world in various ways. The point, however, is to change it. And change, of course, is not an inconvenient and easy situation. So I'm confident that many among the numerous keynote speeches, roundtables, presentations that will be held in the upcoming days will serve the above purpose. So given this, I would like just to thank you again, to welcome you in Athens, and to wish to the conference participants, and especially to the organizers, that I would really like to thank them. Some of them used to teach me the elements of sociological theory, and I feel really, really happy about that. So I wish you every success in the conference. Thank you very much.